How incredibly patient are you guys? Thank you so, so much. I think this is working now. As people sign on, if you could let me know in the comments, give me a thumbs up. I think that horrible buzzing is gone. Oh, I did a test video and it seemed to work. So hopefully we are good. So I'm just going to jump right into the topic for this week's Facebook Live. Why I wanted to do this is I have entrepreneurs reaching out to me all the time asking me advice on how to start a business, how to build your business. They know I started. Oh, I see a thumbs up, so I'm going to assume it's working this time. I hope so. This is persistence. This is what persistence looks like. You need that if you want to be successful in business. But all of those people that reach out to me and are just starting to achieve whatever kind of goal they're aiming for, educational goal, business goal, career goal, whatever. Often for Indigenous people, for marginalized people, women, and every single one of us, when you're starting out, one, there's so many training videos out there you can watch, and two, you don't often relate to them. It sounds like they're talking about a totally different career or different journey. I know in the beginning, when I first started out, it was almost like I had to translate those videos. I watched them and then had to change it to fit what I needed to learn. So even though I'm now 12 years in business and consider myself very successful, I still do training all the time. That's part of my pattern. The better I get, the better I can serve the people I work with. That is my goal, my mission. That is everything to me. So almost daily, at minimum four times a week, I'm listening to a podcast or watching a training video. And last week, I watched 15 Secrets Successful People Know About Time Management by Kevin Kruse. And it made me think of all those people that don't relate to training videos. So what I thought I would do, which is kind of different, is I'm going to give my impression of these 15 secrets. Do I do these? I am a successful person that started from nothing. Did this work for me? Do these rules make sense? And hopefully I'm someone you can relate to. So it'll help you get the most out of these 15 secrets. And by the way, everyone can use time management. So even if you're not starting your own business, hopefully this will help you out. Okay, so the first secret of time management, according to Kevin Kruse, is that time is your most valuable and scarcest resource. 110%. Now, in the beginning, I made a mistake that so many people who go into business make, and that is I still had an employee mindset in that it was calculating how much I would charge based on hourly rate. This is going to take me 4 hours. I'm going to use this fee per hour. That is not the entrepreneur way to do things at all. We price per task. If I'm going to do a if I'm going to do a seminar, there's a fee I charge for the seminar. Whether it took me 2 hours or 20 hours to design that, if it takes me 20 hours, I need to up my game. And it probably did take me 20 hours each in the beginning of my career, and now it so doesn't. But it's the value that I give people. That's what the price is based on. And the reality is, right now, while I'm doing this Facebook Live, I guarantee you someone's reading my book. Someone could be buying my book. Someone could be working on a video course that they bought off my website. That's how you max out your time, using automation. And if you want to hear more about that, send me an email, sandy@sandyboucher.com. Always here to answer your questions. That was one. Second secret, identify most important task and do it first. Okay, so to be honest, I am really good at setting a to-do list for my day. I know now, I'm 57 years old, I've been working for a long time, I know how much I can achieve in a day, and I'm not going to half-ass it. It's my business, I wouldn't do that, and I'm not going to kill myself either. I can now do a very realistic to-do list. So do I do the most important task first? Not necessarily. So I do my blog post first every single morning. And it doesn't take me that long to do. And I know a lot of people hear that and they think, oh my God, if I had to write a blog post every single morning, I'd be stressed right out. I'm an author, remember? That is my jam. That is what I do. I make sense of my world by writing. I have long said it would be easier for me to give up breathing than it would be writing. So I do that first. All the important tasks in every given day are going to get done. They may not be done first. And even on, especially the days when my energy, my motivation is kind of meh, you know, Mondays, I might do small things, a couple small things first, send an email to someone, whatever, so I can check it off and it gets me in that productivity groove and then I'm good. So not necessarily on that one. Number three, work from the calendar, not the to-do list. And what he meant by that is if you have a list of 42 things, you start checking those off. Some are higher priorities than others. You could end up running into trouble with the deadline because you were focusing on something else. My to-do list is based off my calendar. What event is coming next? What deadline? So again, I'm really good at sending the to-do list, but it is always related to the calendar first. So I agree with that one. Number four, to overcome procrastination. And at this point, I'm going to stop and say, I suck at procrastination. I just don't do it. I can't relax if something needs to be done. So I'm going to do it first and then have a guilt-free evening or weekend, whatever the case may be. So I'm probably not the person to ask about overcoming procrastination. But it says, to overcome procrastination, be your future self. If you promise to do it now. Don't put it off. Behave like the person you want to be. I can honestly say when I was taking this training, at this point, I stopped and I was like, am I behaving like the person I want to be? Yes. And it took me a long time to get here. And I'm really thrilled to be able to say that. So if you're not there yet, just keep going. Number five, there will always be more to do. 110%. When I'm done at the end of the day, it's because I'm done everything. I'm done that day's to-do list. The other thing I do, if I end up with a list of a bunch of things to do, I assign time for it. Okay, I'm working for this on Tuesday. It goes in my day book. I'm allotting that time to work on it. This I can't work till Wednesday. I'll let them know I can't do it till Wednesday. So I know everything is going to get done, and then there's no stress. I may not be able to do it today, but I know I've honored it and respected it enough to set time aside. I hope that helps you. Six, always carry a notebook. 110%. I always have a notebook with me. Back to, I think, process my life by writing. Never know when I'm going to come up with a crazy new idea or something that I want to post, a quote that I want to share with you guys. I always have a notebook. And in fact, I have like three different notebooks on the go right now for various different things. Excuse me. Number seven, control your inbox. Check it three times a day and don't just get lost in the new emails. This is new for me. Have to admit it. I run two computer monitors and I always had my email program open on the second one. And just from back in my nonprofit management days, I always answered emails as they came in. It would take 2 seconds to be done and back to what I was doing. And I don't do that anymore. I now minimize the email program and I check it first thing in the morning. I check it at lunchtime and I check it probably around 3 o'clock. So if there is anything urgent, I can do it before the end of the day. And I stay focused on what I'm doing and I'm living my life, which is just awesome. Awesome. Highly suggest you do that. Number eight, schedule and attend meetings at the last resort. Meetings can be such a drain of time. Just like meaning sometimes it's important if you're setting up a new process, if you're just seeing the intent on something, you got to, you know, you're brainstorming, so you got to go back and forth. Some conversations can't be done over email, but that takes up a lot of time, and not everything has to be a meeting. So just keep that in mind. I don't tend to do a lot of meetings. Number 9, say no to everything that doesn't support your immediate goals. Yes. Now, what are my goals? To be a great mom and grandma, to be a good friend, to run a successful business, to be healthy and strong. So if it has something to do with one of those, it's going to get my time and attention. If it's going to go against one of those 4 goals, or just meh, doesn't fit in, then I'm going to say no. And I know some people just got really nervous because I'm suggesting you say no. If you want to live your life on, you got to learn to say no. But otherwise, everyone else is driving your bus. It's true. The sooner you learn that, the better. And I'm saying that as someone who never used to say no. We didn't want to disappoint people. That was more a lack of self-esteem thing than anything else. The more confident I got, the easier. And I'm not rude about it. They just know I'm honoring my journey. Number 10, follow the 20-80 rule, 20% effort, 80% results. I mentioned my daily blog post. That is probably 20% effort. Again, it's not difficult for me, but I get 80% results from that. People, it tends to be how they find me. They fall in love with my blog post first, then they're buying books. Maybe they're taking a course. Maybe they're coming to one of my seminars, but it always seems to be the way they found me was the blog post or my YouTube channel, one of the videos. So same kind of thing. It's so worth it. So don't minimize those things that seem little. It doesn't have to be this huge project every single time. Consistency is what matters. Doing it over and over and over. I've been doing this for 12 years. I don't do mental math 365 days a year times 12 years and so many blog posts I've put out there. You can see why I built a following. Number 11, focus on your unique strengths and passions. I'm going to put this in block caps, like get a t-shirt, put this on a sign where you see it. You won't be successful. You're most successful by being you. Learn from everyone else, but don't ever mimic. Don't be a copy. You are unique. You have a unique view on the world. You have unique experiences that you can share with the world and people that have gone through the same kind of thing. I speak a lot to women in coming out of domestic violence situations because that was my past. And I'm living proof. It doesn't have to be your future that you can put that in the past. That's a unique view. I am an Anishinaabe. I am an Indigenous woman. I look at the world differently than a white corporate dude does. And if I tried to look at the world the way he was, I would disappoint everyone that's trying to follow me. So you are where your strength is. Your strength is in your story, your perspective. Now make sure to do your healing. Do that for you. But when you find your strength, that's what the world needs. Number 12, batch work with reoccurring themes in their days or times. My brain is most active in the morning. I do my best work in the morning. So I tend to stay in the office and do that kind of work in the morning. And then the meetings I put in the afternoon when my brain is working a little bit slower and I can focus on what someone else says. So I definitely batch it together. On Friday, I look at my stats every single Friday. How am I doing? Am I hitting my goals? There's no sense setting a goal if you don't look at your progress. How do you know if you're hitting the targets or not? How can you adjust if you don't ever look at it? That was something I had to learn. So yes, you know your best time. I don't tend to do heavy deadline things on a Monday. My body's going, it's a Monday. But Tuesdays, I'm knocking it out of the park. So know you. Again, your unique strengths. 13, if you do a task in less than 5 minutes, do it immediately. Yeah, you get to check it off. It puts me in productivity mode. If I set it aside, then it's going to bunch up with all the other things, and now it's a huge time commitment. If it's a 2-second thing, do it. Done. Yay, pat on back. You did great. Move on. 14, use early morning to strengthen your mind, body, and spirit. Okay, so what he is saying here is many of the most successful people you can think of, first thing in the morning, they do their exercising, they do their meditation, their visualization. Okay, no. For me, that just doesn't work because, like I said, wake up working. So I do my blog post, I do my social media posts, then I go away from the computer and do my exercising and my visualization and my meditating. So there is no wrong answer. The answer is knowing what you do. Fit the self-care in there. You're as important as anyone you're serving, but do it when it works for you. And last but not least, number 15, productivity is about energy and focus, not time. 110%. If I have to write a proposal and I do it first thing in the morning, it's going to take me 20 minutes. If I try to do it at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, it's going to take me 5 hours because it just doesn't fit my vibe and what works for me. So it's not putting in the time, it's getting the work done. Again, an entrepreneurial spirit, we're not governed by the clock, we're governed by results. You deserve results. So I hope this helped. So there you have it, guys. Those secrets are pretty good. I'm not sure I would have called them secrets. I might even be tempted to come up with my own secrets. I actually did release the 10 lessons or 12 lessons in 12 years. Maybe I'll do that next week. Those ones I wrote based totally on my career. That's actually a really good idea. See, now I need to write that down in my notebook. That's why you carry a notebook. I apologize again for that horrible buzzing that happened earlier. Ah, that was just awful. I had to restart my computer and then it was fine. Mental note for next time. I hope you're doing well. I hope you're safe. I hope you're enjoying the great weather. Tomorrow is National Indigenous Day. I wish I was at a powwow. Not going to lie. Might have to put on my jingle dress and go dance outside just because. Whatever you're doing, enjoy the day, enjoy the week. I love you. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.